this tutorial, I'll show you how to create scribble textures inside After Effects. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. The first option to create a scribble texture is the scribble effect. I've just added a solid to my comp. Next, let's add the scribble effect. You can find it in Effect, Generate, Scribble. For it to work, it needs a mask. Let's add one using the rectangle tool. We drag it across the screen. Next, we need to choose here what mask to use. We only have one, single mask. We choose mask 1. Then we choose the fill type. Inside is the fill. Then we have different edge options, like centered edge or outside edge. Let's keep inside for now. Next, we change the color. We could change the opacity, the angle of the strokes, the stroke width. Then there are a whole bunch of stroke options. The curviness variation for more randomness, spacing, spacing variation, path overlap, and path overlap variation. Then the start and end point, which is like a trim path animator. You can animate the start and end point of the stroke, because if you look at it closely, it's all one stroke. Then there's the wiggle type. Static. Static is like a freeze frame. Smooth is an animation. Jumpy is more like a frame by frame animation. Let's reduce the wiggle per second to around 3. And with composite, you can either add the stroke to your original image, make the background transparent, or reveal the original image. The stroke is like an alpha track mat. This effect is great for a start, but gets you only to a certain point. For one, it only supports 8-bit per channel color, and it doesn't look very handmade. It's all one stroke, which seems unrealistic. So let's try something else. First, we add a new solid. Name it Scribbles, color doesn't matter. And this time we use the turbulent noise effect to create scribbles. You can find it in Effect and Noise and Grain. This effect creates a random noise texture, which we adjust. Let's increase the contrast to around 1500. Decrease the brightness to around minus 220. Then in Transform, we disable uniform scaling and set the scale width to something ridiculous like 6000. The scale height to 5. Complexity 10. In the sub settings, with the sub influence, you can change the style of your lines even more. The brightness basically determines the amount of lines. To animate the lines, we animate the evolution with an expression. Hold Alt if you use a PC or Option if you use a Mac, and click on the stopwatch symbol to add an expression. We add time asterisk 500. The evolution value increases by 500 per second. Next, let's add even more detail to the lines. We add turbulent displays. Let's use the effects and presets window to search for it and add it. We set the amount to 10, the size to 10 as well. Complexity 1. And you can see the lines look much more handmade. A lot more detail. Let's duplicate the effect, Command or Control D, and set the size to 400. To add overall curves to the lines. I mean, who draws a perfectly straight line, right? Let's animate the evolution of this effect with an expression as well. Time asterisk 100 this time. Then let's rotate the lines. We add the transform effect. And set the rotation to around minus 50 degrees, maybe. You can see the height of the solid is not big enough to cover the whole screen. So let's quickly go back into the solid settings and increase the height to 2000 pixels maybe. Seems enough. The screen is covered. Finally, let's reduce the frame rate to calm it down a little bit. We add posterize time. And set frames per second to 4. Awesome. Then we duplicate the layer. Set the blending mode to screen. And rotate the scribbles in the transform effect in the opposite direction. We have a scribble animation that feels very different to the first one. And with infinite possibilities of changing the effect settings, it is very unique. And basic expressions like the time expressions are very helpful and time-saving in the animation process. So if you want to use expressions and don't know where to start, get my free expression sheet. It covers the most important expressions and explains you how to apply them. You should check out my course to learn how to create complex animations with expressions in After Effects. It starts from zero. In 30 lessons, we go through the basics. Basic expressions, responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. Take your animation skills to the next level and learn how to animate with expressions in After Effects. Links are in the description. Awesome, let's try a third method. We choose the pen tool, no fill, a 2 pixel wide stroke. The color, white is fine. Let's zoom in a little bit. Then we draw a scribble. We zoom back out and it is pretty small. Then we add wiggle paths from the drop-down menu here. Let's open it and adjust some settings. We increase the size until it looks chaotic enough. And let's reduce detail to 1 maybe. 2 wiggles per second, points, smooth. Next, let's add a posterized time effect to reduce the frame rate. We use the effects and presets window. Double click on the effect to add it. Let's use 4 frames per second again. And this gets you small decorative scribbles you can add to your animations to emphasize them or whatever. Let's move wiggle paths into the shape 1 group and duplicate it. You got to know 3 different methods on how to create scribble textures. Hope they're useful for you. Check out the expression sheet and my After Effects courses and resources. Links are in the description. On the left, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.